Oi oi, it's Pep Talk UK, it's Frankie B repping the Pep Talk boys, and I'm joined by a local mate of mine. He's up in Manchester, here for the Usyk versus Bellew big fight this weekend. It is Sky Sports boxing pundit Spencer Oliver. How you doing?
How are you doing, my friend? Yeah, I'm really good, man. Been up here since Tuesday now. We come up, done the open workout last night. Both guys look nice and relaxed, look good. Bellew's been trying to get in Usyk's head. You know, he does that. We saw it against David Haye. He done that. He's done a great job doing it. He's been trying to get in Usyk's head. But you know what? Usyk's not been biting. He's not been taking the bait. Last night at the open workout, Usyk looked great. Bellew looked great as well. But Bellew was leaning over, trying to taunt him, trying to get in his head. Usyk's just taking it, you know, all in his stride, very relaxed. But I'm excited for this fight, man. Come Saturday, we're going to expect fireworks. Bellew's told us what he's going to do. He's going to go basically out there, throw everything and the kitchen sink at Usyk. He knows he can't outbox Usyk. He's going to be looking for the knockout. That's the only way he can win, and that's the only way he believes he can win. So he's going to give it everything. You know, we've got the WBC, WBA, IBF and WBO titles all on the line. Bellew wants those. You know, he's had a great career down at light heavyweight. He boxed for the world title. He was weight drained against Adonis Stevenson, got beat, goes up to cruiserweight, wins a WBC title against Makabu in a great performance where he was the underdog. He spent a career being the underdog, and he's a big underdog here on Saturday as well.
That spurs him on.
Yeah, he certainly does, man. Big underdog, and that's the way he likes it. Usyk, he really is the monster of the division. Bellew's highlighted that, you know, all this week. He's got nothing but respect and admiration for Usyk, but he wants them titles, and he's going to take him into a dogfight, and he's looking to look to stop him in the later rounds. Do I believe he can do it? I think he can. I really do. I just think the scene is set. The time is right. Bellew at the moment is an all-time career best. You know, he's about 35 years of age or so, but he's boxing better than he's ever boxed.
He's like a fine wine, isn't he?
He certainly is, and I think that he's going to give it everything on Saturday. You know, the arena is going to be a lot of emotion flying around in there. And I think we're going to see a performance of a lifetime and something really historic and magical going down on Saturday night. And I believe Bellew pulls off a memorable victory.
So Bellew, on his last two fights, has fought at heavyweight. I mean, is it going to be a factor, him coming down in weight to fight Oleksandr Usyk? Will he be weight drained?
You know, he was at heavyweight for 2 years, so that could be a factor. You know, he's going to have to have got it right. Bellew's the ultimate professional. He will do everything correctly. He's meticulous in what he does. So he would have brought the weight down right. I spoke to Dave Caldwell the other day, and he said that everything's been brilliant with the weight. He looks good at the weight. He doesn't look drawn or anything. That's good. And Alexander Usyk's talking about moving up to heavyweight after this fight. Now, at the open workout last night, Usyk looked huge. He looked like he's still got weight to lose. Bellew looked like he was down on the weight and looked good. So, you know, there's a factor for both of them. There's an argument for both of them. Is Usyk struggling and will he move up straight after? Is Bellew going to weaken himself coming down? And we'll only find those answers out on Saturday night.
Because some would say that Tony Bellew, he seemed kind of weight drained against Adonis Stevenson when he came down in weight a few years back. That is why people are looking at that as a factor.
Yeah, no, I don't see it as being a factor. Look, the difference between the Adonis Stevenson ones, that he was down at light heavyweight. Now, Bellew's natural weight is at cruiserweight. That's where he's comfortable. When he moved up to heavyweight, we could see he was fleshy. He talked about, you know, he'd never boxed any of the big guys because they were too big. He would only box someone like David Haye, who really was only a cruiserweight himself anyway. So, yeah, I don't think it's going to be an issue, him coming back down to weight. Not like it was against Adonis Stevenson.
Spencer Oliver, it's been a pleasure. Thanks for your time.
Thank you. Cheers.